Hello, my dear students. In the last class, I explained about bars of varying cross sections, right? And also the principle of superposition. Today's class, we will discuss about the other type. What is that? Bars of composite sections or stress in the composite bar. What is this composite bar? Composite bar, as the name itself indicates, it is a bar made up of two or more different materials joined together. Okay, so how you can define a composite bar? May be defined as a bar made up of two or more different materials joined together in such a manner that the system extends or contracts as one unit equally when subject to tension or compression. Okay, so it is a bar made up of two or more different materials. Okay, it is joined together such that wherever the contracts or extends happens, no, it is always equal. Okay, when it is subjected to tension or compression, that is the meaning of composite bar. Here you have to remember two points while solving example on composite bars. The first one is extension or contraction of the bar is equal. Therefore, strain, that is deformation per unit length, is also equal. So, first point is extension or contraction of the bar is equal. Means what? The deformation is equal in both the sections. Okay, that is the meaning. And second point is the total external load on the bar is equal to the sum of the loads carried by the different materials. Suppose that means if the total load means suppose if it is P, that is equal to sum of the loads carried by the different materials. Suppose there are two different materials, then total load is equal to sum of the two loads, means P is equal to P1 plus P2. That is the meaning. So these two points you have to remember. The first point is extension or contraction of the bar is equal. Second point is the total external load on the bar is equal to the sum of the loads carried by the different materials. Okay. We will see now how to find this. Let us take or consider a composite bar made up of two different materials. Okay, as shown in the figure. See like this. This is the bar made up of two different materials. Suppose this is made up of steel and this is copper. Okay, so how you can analyze this. See P1. P1 is load carried by the bar 1. Here I have not shown where is P1, where is A1, where is sigma 1. Just for your understanding, I am telling you P1 is equal to load carried by the bar 1. Okay. A1 is a cross-sectional area of the bar 1. Then sigma 1, that is stress produced in the bar 1. Then E1, that is Young's modulus of bar 1. Similarly, P2, A2, sigma 2 and E2 are corresponding values of bar 2. Okay, so here P, that is total load on the composite bar because of the two different materials. Okay, L, this is the L, length of the composite bar, and delta L, that is nothing but deformation, elongation of the composite bar. If it is subjected to tensile force, then it is elongation. Here I have shown it is a pulling force, so it is tensile force. That's why I have written elongation, because in the case of tensile force there will be a elongation. Okay, in the if it is the compression, it is subjected to compression force, then there will be shortening in the length. Okay, so according to that, two points I have told, you know. So according to that, total load is equal to P1 plus P2. So the load, sum of the load shared by the two different materials. Okay, now we will see what is stress in the bar. 1. Okay. Suppose here, what is the stress? What is stress? Stress is equal to load divided by area. Load is nothing but P and area is A. So, how we can write sigma 1 is equal to P1 divided by A1. Okay. Stress is equal to load divided by area. How you can write a strain? Strain in the bar. Strain is equal to what? How you can write Young's modulus? E is equal to stress divided by strain, because according to Hooke's law, stress is directly proportional to strain. So, Young's modulus is equal to stress divided by strain. So, strain is equal to stress divided by Young's modulus, right? So, write that. This I have already explained in the last classes. Okay. So, just you have to recall. That's it. Okay. Here, how this is P1 divided by A1? Because this is sigma 1. Stress is equal to P1 divided by A1. So, substitute that P1 divided by A1 into E1. Okay. Strain in the bar 1 is equal to now P1 divided by A1 E1. Okay. Now, next is elongation of the bar. So, how you can write delta L1 is equal to, now this is strain. So, suppose if you have to write the elongation, that is deformation. Deformation in the bar is equal to, deformation is what? PL divided by A into E. We have solved many examples also on this concept. So, delta L1 is P1L divided by A1 E1, because here L is A. That's why it is considered as L only. And elongation of the bar 2, delta L2 is equal to P2L divided by A2 E2. So, according to the 2 points I have told, you know, you have to remember, that is deformation is same, right? Okay. So, delta L1 is equal to delta L2. Deformation of both the bars are equal. So, if you apply that rule, delta L1 is equal to delta L2, what happens? P1L divided by A1 E1 is equal to P2L divided by A2 E2. Okay. Simplify this. This LL get cancelled. So, how you can write, this is my sigma 1 is P1 divided by A1, that is nothing but sigma 1, stress. Stress is equal to sigma 1 divided by E1, that is equal to P2 A2, that is equal to sigma 2 divided by E2, right? So, this is one formula. You have to remember this relationship. Sigma 1 divided by E1 is equal to sigma 2 divided by E2. Okay, so you can write sigma 1 divided by E1 is equal to sigma 2 divided by E2, or how you can write sigma 1 is equal to E1 into sigma 2 divided by E2. So that also you can write. So I have told 2 rules that you have to remember always. The first rule is deformations are equal, and second one is the total load is equal to the sum of the 2 different sections, load shared by the 2 different sections. So that is P is equal to P1 plus P2, that is equal to, how you can write P, stress is equal to load divided by area. So load is equal to stress into area. So P1 is equal to sigma 1 A1 plus sigma 2 A2. Okay. So these 2 formulas you have to always remember. Okay. One is this relationship, and other one is this relationship. You have to remember. Okay. Here one more thing you have to, I have to tell you. Right. See, suppose if you write in terms of sigma 1, how it is now E1 divided by E2, E1 divided by E2, that is into this sigma 2. Right. Okay. You see, like this also you can write. Okay. Here, this E1 divided by A2, this is known as modular ratio. Okay. E1 divided by A2 is known as modular ratio of the 2 materials, and it is denoted by the symbol M. Okay, so this is about the composite bars. So just you remember some points. Like the first point is, I have here considered the composite bar made up of two different materials only. Okay, here in this bar I have considered only two different materials, but this principle may be extended for a bar made up of more than two different materials also. Okay, so this point you have to remember, it is not only for two different materials, it can be for more than two different materials also. Then second point is, if the length of the two parts are different, then elongation should be separately calculated and equated. See here, I have considered the length of same length, but it may be the lengths also different. That time you have to consider the elongations separately. Okay, then you have to equate. Then the third one is the ratio of E1 divided by E2 is known as modular ratio of the two material and is denoted by the letter M. So that here I explained, no, here this one, sigma 1 is equal to E1 divided by E2 into sigma 2. So this E1 divided by E2, that is called as modular ratio and is denoted by the symbol M. Okay, so this is about the bars of composite sections. So we will see one problem, numerical, so you'll understand. Okay, so let us consider one example, a reinforced concrete circular section of 50,000 mm square cross sectional area carries 6 reinforcing bars whose total area is 500 mm square. Find the safe load the column can carry if the concrete is not to be stressed more than 3.5 MPa. Take modular ratio for steel and concrete as 18. Okay, so what it is here, like this, the figure is given. It is of a circular cross section and of 6 reinforcing bars here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 reinforcing bars of that area is 500 mm square. So you have to find the safe load. Okay, area of the column is given, the total area is given, 50,000 mm square, and number of the reinforcing bars are 6. Then total area of the steel bar, that is equal to 500 mm square, is given. Then stress is equal to 3.5 MPa or 3.5 into 10 to 6 Newton per meter square or 3.5 Newton per millimeter square. Then take modular ratio for steel and concrete as 18. What is this modular ratio? I will explain that it is the ratio of two different materials. Okay, here it is given steel and concrete. So first write steel to concrete is equal to 18. So how you can calculate? First you know the total, how you can calculate the total area of the concrete you have to find. What is that total area of the concrete? That is whole area of circular section minus this reinforcing bars, that you have to deduct, because we want the area of the concrete only. Now we have to deduct the area of the this reinforcing bars. Okay, so that is given. So 50,000 minus 500, that is equal to 49,500 mm square. Okay, next, stress in the steel. What is stress in the steel? See, you have that formula I have explained while considering, explaining about the theory. So sigma s divided by sigma s is equal to es divided by ec, Young's modulus for steel to Young's modulus for concrete into sigma c is equal to, what is this, sigma es into ec, that is this value is equal to 18, it is given here, into sigma c. What is sigma c? It is given 3.5 newton per mm square. Substitute, so you will get 63 newton per mm square. This is stress in the steel. Okay, next, the safe load of the column you have to calculate. What is safe load? Safe load is equal to total load is equal to
the load taken by the steel bars as well as the concrete, right? So what is that? P is equal to P1 plus P2. Okay, so total load is equal to P is equal to P1 plus P2. Okay, P1 plus P2 here. Okay, so what is this P1? P1 is equal to what is stress? Stress is equal to load divided by area, right? So P is equal to stress into area. So that's why it is written here. Here instead of this, you can write instead of P1, this is PS and this is PC. It is not 2, okay? It is C. So PS is equal to here. PS is equal to sigma S into AS, okay? That is here. Similarly, C now. PC is equal to what? Sigma C into AC. So substitute. So what is sigma S? Sigma S is equal to 63. So substitute 63 into AS. AS is 500 plus what is sigma C? Sigma C is equal to, it is given, stress in the concrete is, should not be more than 3.5. Substitute and the only area of the concrete is 49,500. Substitute, you will get this answer. Okay, this is in Newton because all these terms are in Newton. So if you wanted to keep convert into kilonewton, so divided by 1000, so you will get this answer. Okay, or you can keep like this also, no problem. So in this way you can solve the problem of a composite bar. So we will see the other different type of problem in the next class. Thank you.